guess that I'ma be okay.
Say it's gonna feel me now.
I feel like I'ma live somehow.
Your love never meant much to me. Love never meant much to me. Your love never meant much to me.
Baseball from the Big Apple. We're at Yankee Stadium in the Bronx. This afternoon, we've got an interleague pairing of division leaders between the Phillies and the New York Yankees. Yankee baseball starts now. Jameson Taillon is ready to go as he'll be on the mound for the Yanks. What's your take on him, Dan?
Matt, we're getting a chance to see a very talented right-hander here in Jameson Taillon. His stuff has always played well. It's just a matter of staying lucky and staying healthy. This guy has what it takes to be a solid major league pitcher.
Gio Urshela is into the ballgame as a defensive replacement. He'll be the new shortstop here. And now, Willie Castro. And we are ready for some daytime baseball. First pitch coming, here it is. And we are underway from Yankee Stadium as the first pitch is taken for ball one. Well, this Yankee ball club entering play this afternoon here. They come in trying to rebound after a loss that snapped a modest three-game winning streak.
Yeah, Matty, you never know right here. Interleague game, when the weather gets cold, this could be a nice harbinger to what we're going to see in the Fall Classic right here. Two first-place teams going to lock horns in a battle, and I'm jacked up. Hey, just a nice piece of hitting right there. He's able to keep his hands inside that ball, stay square as long as possible, and feed it into the opposite field for a base hit.
At the plate, Joaquin Dias, as he'll follow one into the dirt and come up empty for the first strike. And he's a guy looking to break out in a big way. Hasn't been getting the results he or his club have been hoping for. Here's the 0-1 pitch. Missed low and inside with it, 1-1. And there are the umpires assigned to this one. Balls and strikes belong to Mr. Jerry Hillsdale.
You know, D-Row, I think Jerry Hillsdale is a very good hitter's umpire. Doesn't give much on the edges. He's going to make you put the ball over the plate.
Oh, I love me some Jerry Hillsdale. You have to come over those 17 inches. He ain't giving you anything on the outside corner, and that's the way it should be.
And he'll steer clear of the flying debris to make the catch here for the first down. And that brings up Javi Baez. First at bat for him here, and he enters play seventh in the National League in round trippers.
Yeah, he's blasted four home runs in his last 10 games, too, and he's got that power stroke working right now.
This guy's an absolute nightmare to opposing pitcher. Power to all fields, and he'll take that ball away and drive it for opposite field power.
Swung on, but it's pulled foul wide of third. Can't find the zone there as he lays off the breaking ball. Now the fastball is swung on and missed. And that misses 2-2. Working for the punch out and the offering. Started to go. Did he hold up in time? Yes, says the first base umpire. It's ball three now. And it's fouled away.
Lucky he got a piece right there. He was definitely late on that pitch after seeing a previous off-speed pitch.
Fouled off. Castro leads off first with one away. And he can only battle for so long as he's finally set down here after an eight-pitch at-bat.
One thing to know is not all strikeouts are created equal. Right there, he goes down on strikes, but he really made that guy on the mound work for it. And when you're doing that in the first inning, it can have an effect on how deep he's going to be able to go into this start. There's a big difference between that and going down on three or four pitches.
Here's Bryce Harper now, having a very nice year, currently second in the NL batting chase.
Fantastic season all the way around. Not only does this guy just get on base by base hits, but he also leads the league in slugging percentage, so he's up there doing a lot of damage.
Down the first baseline, scooped up, and he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Aaron Nola is on the mound for game two. Dan, any thoughts?
Hey, this guy is one of the better pitchers in the league, and one stat that jumps out, take a look at that strikeout-to-walk ratio. That's about as good as it gets. And look for him to dominate in this one.
Here's Starling Marte. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
Leading off for the Yankees, the center fielder, Starling Marte.
The pitch. Dan Dero, as we take a look at our visiting club as they take the field in this scoreless ball game, they've got to be considered the hottest team in baseball right now as they come in winners of 9 of their last 10 ball games.
Yeah, Maddie, this team finds itself with a huge lead, double digits right now, and climbing, playing really good baseball. Some people will say, oh, you don't want to have that big a lead, you start resting on your laurels. I look at it the other way, man. You've earned the right to kind of get some guys off their feet if the manager wants. There's a lot of different ways you can go about it. This team's focused and playing really good baseball. I would not worry about it. Keep pushing the throttle.
And another foul ball. Here's a ball swung on and hit high and deep down the left field line. And this will stay fair. Home run. It's a solo shot for Starling Marte. Home run number 9 on the year as the Yankees will grab a 1-0 lead.
Yeah, I can remember when leadoff hitters were these little speedy guys who would try to leg out little numbers or draw walks. Well, that time has passed, and guys like this with pop at the plate can sometimes go deep as well as anybody in the lineup.
Here's the second baseman, DJ LeMahieu. First shot for him here as he comes in currently leading the junior circuit in hitting.
Hey, not a bad year for a second baseman. There's some really good two sackers out there, but second basemen aren't typically where you expect to have one of your better hitters.
First pitch coming. Here it is. In there for strike one.
If you're on the mound right here, you got to trust your catcher and execute. You know who's coming up to the plate.
Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Dias is right there, one down.
Batting third, the designated hitter, Aaron Hicks.
So now to the plate, Aaron Hicks. One run in and one gone so far this inning. Ready to deal. Here comes the first pitch. Good swing. Just got to try and straighten that one out. Bases are empty. One man out. That's taken. Now it's 0-2.
That's why this guy is great. Never misses over the heart of the plate. It's got electric stuff, but pinpoint control to all four quadrants.
Popped him up. And he'll put this one away in foul territory for the second out. Here's big Aaron Judge. He enters play hitting down in the 240s for the year. Ready. ready to deliver. Here comes the first pitch.
Hey, I still believe in my heart the best pitch is a well-executed fastball down and away, and that's exactly what that is. He swings at that. That's off the end of the bat. That's not hard contact at all. And that's
well, the play's been made, and with it comes the end of the inning. But they're off to a good start as they pick up a run on this solo shot. We'll head to the top of the second. New York off to a 1-0 lead. Now to the plate, Giancarlo Stanton. He enters play at number 6 in National League batting average.
What a powerhouse season in the top 10 in home runs and runs batted in. He's also one of the most feared hitters in all of baseball.
Outfield shaded a bit to left center, the first pitch. Well, there are the judges' chambers, and what a cool thing it's become here in the Bronx, and well-deserved for Aaron Judge, of course, with the way he exploded onto the scene as a rookie in 2017.
What a magical year 2017 was for Aaron Judge. The slogan, "All Rise," fit him perfectly. What's really cool about it was the Yankees weren't even sure he was going to make the team coming out of spring training. He emerged into the scene, was the talk of baseball going into the All-Star break, finished that off with a powerhouse into the season, one of the best young players the game in baseball has seen in a long time. All rise, Aaron Judge.
To 1-2 now. And a slider runs away from him there, and the count levels at 2-2. Fouled away. Fastball called, strike 3, and there's the first out of the inning. And that'll bring in the switch hitting Francisco Lindor. And he's got that batting lineup near the 300 mark entering play. First offering. And he fouls this one off.
Hey, when you're featuring a mid-90s fastball like this pitcher, attack with that pitch. Get ahead. Get the offense on their toes. That opens up the off-speed pitches later in the game.
Frazier will range to his left as he tracks this one down in left center for the second out of the inning. Rowdy Tellez the next to bat, and he's carrying a batting average of just over 300, so clearly he's been a productive player with the bat in his hand so far. And he lays off there 1-0. And it's fouled away. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Count is 1-2 now. Yankees lead this 1-0 here in inning number 2. Looked like the fastball got away from him there. It's ball 2.
Well, 2 straight fastballs inside haven't put him away. So now it'll be interesting to see what he turns to.
Tough curveball that time, but he's able to make a little contact to keep this at bat going. Not where he wanted that fastball to be, and it's 3-2 now. Now the payoff pitch home. And this one misses high for ball 4, and they have themselves a 2-out base runner.
Batting 8, the catcher, JT.
So a runner at first with 2 away, and that brings up JT Realmuto. From the stretch, high in the air out towards shallow right. Judge is under it. He handles it easily, and the inning is over. ready to go for the last half of the inning. And next to bat will be the first baseman, Luke Voit. Infield in the overshift here. Now the pitch.
No, that's down.
Nola has both great strikeout stuff and exceptional command on the mound to go with it. A rare combination, but one that makes him one of the best in our sport.
Matty V, you talked about it. He doesn't walk a whole lot of guys. Well, if you don't walk a lot of guys, that means you have to throw the ball in the strike zone. And when you do, with great stuff like this guy has, he racks up the strikeouts. There aren't a lot of guys that get strikeouts by throwing the ball in the strike zone. This is one of the few that does it.
Two balls and a strike to the Yankees first baseman. Swung on and missed, and it's even at 2-2. And he takes strike three called on the fastball, one gone.
You know what was really impressive to me about that strikeout? He fell behind 2-0 to start the at bat. That's a pretty bad place to be, but then he kind of refocused himself and came right back with three quality pitches in a row to sit him down. That's not easy to do, but now his focus has to hone in on getting ahead on the next guy.
Gleyber Torres comes on with one gone here as he looks at a called strike one. That's strike two on a well-placed changeup around the knees.
Well, they got to him in the first inning, which is huge, but he looks a lot more settled into this ball game right now. He's not the kind of pitcher you want to let get into a groove out there.
And he couldn't get him to chase the 0-2 fastball. It's 1-2. One out, nobody on. Swing and a miss on the changeup, and there are two gone. Up next, Clint Frazier. And as you take a look at the splits here, he's actually better against right-handed pitching this season. And now the first pitch. Pulls the string on that one. One strike. Stung into the gap in right center for what should be extra bases. He's around first, heading for two. And now he'll get into scoring position with two away. So perhaps some new life in the inning here with a two-out double in the second as he tacks on to his total, currently third best on the Yankee ball club. That'll bring in Giovanni Urshela as he'll take a look at ball one. He enters play with 14 home runs to his credit this year. Ready with the 1-0. And a fastball here that's taken for ball two.
He's going to have a talk with the umpire after this half inning. Because if he's not going to get those calls, he's got to come a little bit more over the heart of the plate. And that usually means damage done.
To 2-2 now.
Hey, I love the mindset of this pitcher right here. Try and dominate and execute a fastball in, and then get the guy sitting inside trying to be quick to everything, and then pull the string a little bit on a nasty changeup.
Sent on the ground out to second. And nothing will come of the two-out double as the inning is over. Two-out double left stranded. More matinee baseball here on a Wednesday afternoon following this. All set for the start of the inning, and that'll bring up Alec Bohm. Ready to deliver. Here comes the first pitch.
The offense better get it going right here, because they certainly can tell from their dugout this guy is carrying himself with a presence out on the mound. He's got feel for all his pitches.
LeMahieu's got it. Throw to first in time, and the leadoff man is gone to start the third. So one gone now as you get a look there at where the Yankees stand currently in the American League East. Castro. Next to hit, Willie Castro. He collected a base hit his first time up.
Yeah, guys, still the only hit in this game so far. They've been pretty well shut down. Guys on the mound have really much controlled the whole outcome up until this point.
Throw gets him, two down.
The center fielder.
Next, here is Joaquin Diaz. Now here's the first offering. And that misses for ball one.
This could be a huge win for the guy on the mound if he's able to get out of this inning 1-2-3 and start fresh next inning with the middle of the order.
Fouled off.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating and feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
1-2 now. Into the windup and the pitch. Breaking ball that time that misses out of the zone.
That hook stayed up in the zone. You can see he struggled with that curveball early. He's trying to find that release point with his off-speed pitches. We'll have to see if he can find the feel for that thing moving forward.
Two out, nobody on. High in the air out to center field. Marte is under it. And that ends the inning.
Welcome back. As the Yankees prepare for their third turn through the order, fans of the Bronx Bombers have been treated to quite a bit of production from this lineup so far this year. They come into the day tops in the majors in team batting average. And talking with some of the players and coaches prior to the game, many of them told me that's something they take a lot of pride in. Batting average isn't as highly valued as it once was, but they said it's a clear indication that they're doing a lot of good things in the batter's box to help the team collect W's. Guys?
All right, Heidi, thank you.
Leading off for the Yankees.
So now here is Reese McGuire as we move on to the bottom of inning number three. First offering on its way. Now the 1-0. A little bouncer. The 1-1 is taken for strike two. Lifted in the air out towards left center. Stanton has a read on it. Looks it into his glove, and there's one gone. No one on with one down, and that'll bring up Starling Marte.
In the last at-bat, that breaking ball was really up in the zone. Not a good spot for a pitcher to throw the off-speed pitch. If he wants to come back and throw that in this at-bat, he better get it down below the knees.
The 1-0 home is a fastball taken high for a ball. Bases are empty, one man out. 2-1 the count. Here now the 2-2.
Hey, having AB right here, I know it's frustrating the heck out of the pitcher. You keep fouling these pitches off, maybe.
This is hit high and deep out to left. Stanton looking up. See you later. Over the wall, a home run. It's a solo shot off the bat of Starling Marte. His second home run of the game. And this is now a 2-0 lead for the Yankees.
Well, he's given up two long balls in just 2 1/3 innings of work. So it seems as though they might have his number here. Not sure how much more the manager wants to see. He needs to turn it around quick if he wants to stay in this one for a while.
And that sends DJ LeMahieu into the box. And on the first pitch, he grounds foul. 0-for-1 for him here in this one. Off the plate, one ball, one strike. One out, nobody on. Oh, they have him looking awfully confused up there right now. It's 1-2.
Step out of the box and wash that one off, because that was an ugly swing.
And did he hold up in time? A look down, and no, he went around. It's strike three. Next will be the designated hitter, Aaron Hicks. 0-for-1 here in the early going. First pitch of the AB now. As it's grounded sharply to first, he's got it, and he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. The Yanks able to add on one more via the solo home run. We're through three in the Bronx. It's now 2-0 New York.